Okay, it looks good here. If you guys think I'm good, can get started. Excellent. Hey, this is what I'm eating right now. A little bit of an espresso help. Okay, some music.
How does a bastard, orphan, son of a whore and a Scotsman, dropped in the middle?
For those who didn't hear this last time, this is some music from the what I think will be one of the most critically acclaimed shows on Broadway, certainly of the year, if not all time. It's Hamilton, and so it's good music for me to get excited for this challenge, because this is a good one. I only got a little bit of a read, but I think it's going to be tough. Slaves were being slaughtered and carted away. Across the waves, he struggled and kept his guard up. Inside, he was longing for something to be a part of. The brother was ready to beg, steal, borrow, or barter. Then a hurricane came. Devastation reigned. Our man saw his future drip, dripping down the train. Put a pencil to his temple, connected it to his brain, and he wrote his first refrain, a testament to his pain. Well, the word got around, they said this kid is insane, man. Took up a collection just to send him to the mainland. Get your education, don't forget from whence you came, and the world's gonna know your name. What's your name, man? Alexander Hamilton. By the way, a question was asked in the Piercing the Veil that's going to be published tomorrow regarding the future of Medrawd, and I used this song as a hint as to, you know, whether Medrawd was ever going to show up again. It's obscure. Left him with nothing but ruined pride. Something new inside a boy saying, Alex, you gotta fend for yourself. He started retreating and reading every treatise on the shelf. There would have been nothing left to do for someone less astute. He would have been dead and destitute without a cent or restitution. Started working, clerking for his late mother's landlord, trading sugar cane and rum and all the things he can't afford. Scamming for every book he can get his hands on. Planning for the future. Winter King, it's certainly a very different look at the story of Alexander Hamilton told by all immigrants. Everyone in this play is in this country considered minorities, black, African Americans, Puerto Ricans, anybody who really is an immigrant here. And the author wanted to make that, or was, and still talks about how important that was to him and his family coming to this country. And he wanted to tell the story of Hamilton through non-traditional eyes, which is always, you know, the founding fathers of these, you know, men and certainly some women who were involved at a very different level. And so I think it's brilliant. I think everything about the show is brilliant. The acting, I'm sure, is quite good. The singing, the rapping is amazing. So hopefully you'll like it. And I think I got at least a start on this story. This is definitely gonna be more challenging. Good choice, guys and gals.
New York City.
That depends. Who's asking?
Oh, well, sure. Sir, I'm Alexander Hamilton. I'm at your service, sir. I have been looking for you.
I'm getting nervous.
Sir, I heard your name at Princeton. I was seeking an accelerated course of study. When I got sort of out of sorts with a buddy of yours, I may have punched him. It's a blur. Sir, he handles the financials.
You punched the bursar.
Yes, I wanted to do what you did, graduate in two and join the revolution. He looked at me like I was stupid. I'm not stupid. So how'd you do it? How'd you graduate so fast?
It was my parents' dying wish before they passed.
You're an orphan. Of course, I'm an orphan. God, I wish there was a war, then we could prove that we're worth more than anyone bargained for.
Can I buy you a drink?
That would be nice.
While we're talking, let me offer you some free advice. Talk less.
What?
Smile yes. more. Don't let them know what you're against or what you're for.
You can't be serious.
You wanna get ahead.
Zubek, I yes. couldn't agree more. I have been absolutely listening to this almost nonstop for many months. It's incredible. It's just an absolutely amazing soundtrack. And hoping to get to see it on Broadway. Doubtful I'll be able to see it with the original cast. The actor who plays King George is leaving, I think, this summer. And I'm sure some of the other folks will leave as well. All right, so I said this one's going to be challenging. I'm going to start with the idea that Travis here, I'm going to have to make some notes for this one. I won't just be able to write it like I did last time. So this is going to be tough. No more sex, pour me another bruise, son. Let's raise a couple more to the revolution. Well, if it ain't the pride to your Christian college. Aaron Burr, give us a verse, drop some knowledge. Good luck with that, you're taking a stand. You spit, I'ma sit, we'll see where we land.
The revolution's imminent, what do you stall for?
If you stand for nothing, Burr, what'll you fall for?
Ooh, who are you?
Who are you?
Who are you? Who is this kid? What's he gonna do?
I am not throwing away my shot. I am not throwing away my shot. Hey, yo, I'm just like my country. I'm young, scrappy, and hungry, and I'm not throwing away my shot. I'ma get a scholarship to King's College. I probably shouldn't brag, but dag, I'm amazed and astonished. The problem is I got a lot of brains, but no polish. I gotta holler just to be heard.
Message from my son. Be right back.
I'm a diamond in the rough. A shining piece of coal. Trying to reach my goal. My power of speech. Unimpeachable. Only 19. My mind is older. These New York City streets get cold. I shoulder every burden, every disadvantage I've learned to manage. I don't have a gun to brandish. I walk these streets famished.
So whoever came up with this one, again, congratulations. It's gonna be tough.
We are meant to be
a colony that runs independently. Meanwhile, Britain keeps shitting on us endlessly. Essentially, they tax us relentlessly. Then King George turns around, runs a spending. He ain't never gonna set his descendants free, so there will be a revolution in this century. Enter me,
he says in parentheses.
Don't be shocked when your history book mentions me. I will lay down my life if it sets us free. Eventually, you'll see my ascendancy. And I am not throwing away my shot. I am not throwing away my shot. And yo, I'm just like my country. I'm young, scrappy, and hungry, and I'm not throwing away my shot. I am not throwing away my shot. I am not throwing away my shot. Hey, yo, I'm just like my country. I'm young, scrappy, and hungry, and I'm not throwing away my shot. It's time to take a shot.
I dream of life without a monarchy. The unrest in France will lead to anarchy. Anarchy, how you say? How you saw anarchy? When I fight, I make the other side panic.
All right, I think I might have this one. This is gonna be tough. This is gonna be really tough. Don't know if I can certainly do it in the time that's left, but this one would. This is gonna be good. I like this. I like a challenge.
Geniuses, lower your voices. You keep out of trouble and you double your choices. I'm with you, but the situation is fraught. You've got to be carefully taught. If you talk, you're gonna get shot.
Bird, check what we got. Mr. Lafayette, hard rock like Lancelot. I think your pants look hot. Lawrence, I like you a lot. Let's hatch a plot blacker than the kettle calling the pot. What are the odds that God will put us all in one spot? Pop in a squad and conventional wisdom, like it or not. A bunch of revolutionary manumission abolitionists. Position, show me where the ammunition is.
Sometimes I get overexcited, shoot off at the mouth. I never had a group of friends before. I promise that I'll make y'all proud.
Let's get this guy in front of a crowd.
I am not throwing away my shot. I am not throwing away my shot. Hey, yo, I'm just like my country. I'm young, scrappy, and hungry, and I'm not throwing away my shot. I am not throwing away my shot. I am not throwing away my shot. Hey, yo, I'm just like my country. I'm young, scrappy.
Imagine death so much it feels more like a memory. When's it gonna get me? In my sleep, 7 feet ahead of me. If I see it coming, do I run or do I let it be? Is it like a beat without a melody? See, I never thought I'd live past 20. Where I come from, some get half as many. Ask anybody why we live it fast. Can we laugh, reach for a flask? We have to make this moment last. That's plenty, scratch that. This is not a moment, it's the movement. We're all the hungriest brothers with something to prove. When foes oppose us, we take an honest stand. We roll like Moses, claiming our promised land. And if we win our independence, is that a guarantee of freedom for our descendants? Or will the blood we shed begin an endless cycle of vengeance and death with no defendants? I know the action in the street is exciting, but Jesus, between all the bleeding and fighting, I've been reading and writing. We need to handle our financial situation. Are we a nation of states? What's the state of our nation? I'm past patiently waiting, I'm passionately smashing every expectation, every action's an act of creation. I'm laughing in the face of casualties and sorrow. For the first time, I'm thinking past tomorrow.
And I am not throwing away my shot. I am not throwing away my shot. Hey, yo, I'm just like my country. I'm young, scrappy, and hungry, and I'm not throwing away my shot. We gonna rise up.
I may not live to see our glory.
I may not live to see our glory.
But I will gladly join the fight.
I'm increasing the text size. How's that, guys?
When our children tell our story.
And when our children tell our story.
They'll tell the story.
Let me know if this is good.
Let's have another round tonight.
Let's have another round tonight.
Let's have another round tonight.
Raise a glass to freedom. Something they can never take away. No matter what they tell you, raise a glass to the four of us. Tomorrow there'll be more of us telling the story of tonight.
They'll tell the story of tonight.
Raise a glass to freedom, something they can never take away.
No matter what they tell you.
Let's have another round tonight. Raise a glass to the four of us. Tomorrow there'll be more of us telling the story of tonight.
Let's have another round tonight.
They'll tell the story of tonight.
Raise a glass to freedom.
They'll tell the story of tonight.
Raise a glass to freedom.
They'll tell the story of tonight.
Than going downtown and slumming it with the poor. They pull up in their carriages and gawk at the students in the common just to watch them talk. Take Philip Schuyler, the man is loaded. Uh-oh, but little does he know that his daughters, Peggy, Angelica, Eliza, sneak into the city just to watch all the guys.
Work, work.
Angelica.
Work, work.
Eliza.
And Peggy.
Work, work.
Daddy doesn't need to know. Daddy's
born in a rush next to someone looking pretty. Excuse me, miss, I know it's not funny, but your perfume smells like your daddy's got money. Mm-hmm. While you're slumming in the city in your fancy heels, you're searching for an urchin who can give you ideals.
Sir, you disgust me.
Ah, so you disgust me. I'm a trust fund baby, you can trust me.
I've been reading Common Sense by Thomas Paine. So men say that I'm intense or I'm insane. You want a revolution, I want a revelation. So listen to my declaration. We hold these truths to be self-evident, that all men are created equal. And when I meet Thomas Jefferson, I'ma compel him to include women in the sequel. Work! Look around, how lucky we are to be alive right now. Look around, and how lucky we are to be alive right now. History is happening in Manhattan, and we just happen to be in the greatest city in the world. In the greatest city in the world. Cause I'm the crown, so let's say that I'm intense, I'm insane. You want a revolution, I want a revelation. So listen to my declaration. We hope these truths to be self-evident, that I'm an unbegated equal. Look around, how lucky we are to be alive right now. History is happening in Manhattan, and we just happen to be in the greatest city in the world. In the greatest city in the world.
Work, work.
Angelica.
Work, work.
Eliza.
And Peggy.
Work.
The Schuyler sisters.
Work, work.
We're looking for a minor.
Work, work.
Hey.
Work, work.
And I present free thoughts on the proceedings of the Continental Congress. Heed not the rabble who scream revolution. They have not your interest at heart.
Oh my God, tear this dude apart.
Chaos and bloodshed are not a solution. Don't let them lead you astray. This Congress does not speak for me. They're playing a dangerous game. I pray the king shows you his mercy. For shame, for shame.
Yeah. Heed not the rabble. You all unravel at the sound of screams. But the revolution is coming.
They have not your interest at heart.
I listen to you with a straight face.
Chaos and bloodshed already haunt a solution.
And even talk. And what about Boston?
You
Boston and all that we've lost, and you talk
this
about
Congress does not speak for
my
me.
My dog speaks more eloquently.
It may a dangerous dream.
Your mind is
I
the
pray
same.
The king shows you his mercy.
Is he in Jersey?
For shame.
For the revolution. Again, I'm gonna scream. Honestly, look at me, please don't read.
Not your interest.
Don't modulate the key, then not debate with me. Why should a tiny island across the sea regulate the price of tea?
Alexander, please, for I'd rather be divisive than indecisive. Drop the niceties.
Silence, a message from the king. A message from the king. A message from the king.
You're making me mad. Remember, despite our estrangement, I'm your man. You'll be back soon, you'll see. You remember you belong to me. You'll be back, time will tell. You remember that I served you well. Oceans rise, empires fall. We have seen each other through it all. And when push comes to shove, I will send a fully armed battalion to remind you of my love. Da 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 da.
subject, my loyal, royal subject, forever and ever.
I knew that I was poor, I knew it was the only way to rise up. If they tell my story, I am either gonna die on the battlefield in glory or rise up. I will fight for this land, but there's only one man who can give us a command so we can rise up. Understand, it's the only way to rise up, rise up. Here he comes.
Here comes the general.
Ladies and gentlemen.
Here comes the general.
The moment you've been waiting for.
Here comes the general.
The pride of Mount Vernon.
Here comes the general.
To Washington.
We are outgunned, outmanned, outnumbered, outplanned. We gotta make an all-out stand. Hey, yo, I'm gonna need a right-hand man. Can I be real a second? For just a millisecond. Down my guard to tell the people how I feel a second. Now I'm the model of a modern major general, the venerated Virginian veteran whose men are all lining up to put me up on a pedestal, writing letters to relatives embellishing my elegance and eloquence. But the elephant is in the room. The truth is in your face when you hear the British cannons go boom. Any hope of success is fleeting. How can I keep leading when the people I'm leading keep retreating? We put a stop to the bleeding as the British take Brooklyn. Night takes Rook, but look, we are outgunned, outmanned, outnumbered, outplanned. We gotta make an all-out stand. Hey, yo, I'm gonna need a right-hand man. Incoming!
They're battering down the battery, check the damages. We gotta stop them and rob them of their advantages. Let's take a stand with the stamina God has granted. Hamilton won't abandon the ship, yo. Let's steal the cannon.
Shaboom! Goes the cannon, watch the blood in this shit spray. And boom! Goes the cannon, we're abandoning Kipps Bay. And boom! There's another shipping. We just lost Southern tipping. We gotta run to Harlem quick, we can't afford another slip. Guns and horses giddy up. I decide to divvy up my forces. This skittish as the British cut the city up. This close to giving up. Facing mass scrutiny, I scream in the face of this mass mutiny. Are these the men with which I am to defend America? We ride at midnight, Manhattan in the distance. I cannot be everywhere at once, people. I'm in dire need of assistance.
Your Excellency, sir. Who are you?
Aaron Burr, sir. Permission to state my case.
As you were.
Sir, I was a captain under General Montgomery until he caught a bullet in the neck in Quebec. Well, in summary, I think that I could be of some assistance. I admire how you keep firing on the British from a distance. I have some questions, a couple of suggestions on how to fight instead of fleeing west.
Yes.
Well,
Your Excellency, you wanted to see me.
Hamilton. Come in. Have you met Burr?
Yes, sir. We keep meeting.
As I was saying, sir, I look forward to seeing your strategy play out.
Burr,
sir, close the door on your way out.
Have I done something wrong, sir?
On the contrary. I called you here because our odds are beyond scary. Your reputation precedes you, but I have to laugh.
Sir?
Hamilton, how come no one can get you on their staff?
Sir!
Don't get me wrong. You're a young man of great renown. I know you stole British cannons when we were still downtown. Nathaniel Green and Henry Knox wanted to hire you.
Yeah, to be their secretary. I don't think so.
Now, why are you upset?
I'm not.
It's all right you want to fight. You've got a hunger. I was just like you when I was younger. Head full of fantasies of dying like a martyr.
Yes.
Dying is easy, young man. Living is harder.
Why are you telling me this?
Being honest, I'm working with a third of what our Congress has promised. We are a powder keg about to explode. I need someone like you to lighten the load. So?
I am not going to take my shot. I am not going to take my shot. And you were just like my country and young, scrappy and hungry.
I am not throwing away my shot.
Son,
we are outgunned, outmanned.
You need all the help you can get. I have some friends. Lawrence Mulligan, Marquis de Lafayette. Okay, what else?
Outnumbered, outmanned.
We need some spies on the inside. Some king's men who might let some things slide.
I'll write to Congress and tell them we need supplies. We rally the guys, master the element of surprise. I'll rise above my station, organize your information till we rise to the occasion of our new nation. Sir,
here comes the general.
Son of a whore, go on and on, grow into more of a phenomenon. Watch this obnoxious, arrogant, loudmouth father. Be seated at the right hand of the father. Washington hires Hamilton right on sight. But Hamilton still wants to fight, not right. Now Hamilton's skill with the quill is undeniable. But what do we have in common? We're reliable with the ladies. To the flower.
Ladies.
Looks, proximity to power.
Ladies.
They delighted and distracted them. Martha Washington named her feral tomcat after him.
That's true.
1780, a winter's ball. And the Schuyler sisters are the envy of all. Yo, if you could marry a sister, rich son.
Is it a question of if Burr or which one?
Your service.
If it takes fighting a war for us to meet, it will have been worth it.
I'll leave you to it.
1 week later, I'm writing a letter nightly. Now my luck gets better every letter that you write me. Laughing at my sister because she wants to form a harem.
I'm just
dollop of fame. All I have is my honor, a tolerance for pain, a couple of college credits, and my top-notch brain. Insane, your family brings out a different side of me. Peggy confides in me, Angelica tried to take a bite of me. No stress, my love for you is never in doubt. We'll get a little place in Harlem and we'll figure it out. I've been living without a family since I was a child. My father left, my mother died. I grew up on wild, but I'll never forget my mother's face. That was real. As long as I'm alive, Eliza, I swear to God you'll never feel so.
Satisfied. may not live to see our glory.
I may not live to see our glory.
But I've seen wonders great and small.
I've seen wonders great and small.
Because if the tomcat can get married,
if Alexander can get married,
there's hope for our ass after all.
With a glass to freedom.
Hey!
Something you will never see again.
No matter what she tells you,
let's have another round tonight.
There's a glass to the four of us.
Oh,
to the newly not four of us.
Ah, we'll tell the story of tonight.
Let's have another round.
Well, if it isn't Aaron Burr,
sir,
I didn't think that you would make it.
To be sure, I came to say congratulations for the first, Burr. I see the whole gang is here.
You are the worst, Burr.
Ignore them. Congrats to you, Lieutenant Colonel. I wish I had your command instead of manning George's journal.
No, you don't.
Yes, I do.
Now be sensible. From what I hear, you've made yourself indispensable.
Well, I heard you got a special someone on the side, Bird.
Is that so?
What are you trying to hide, Bird?
I should go.
No, these guys should go.
What?
No.
Leave us alone,
man.
It's all right, Bird. I wish you'd brought this girl with you tonight.
You're very kind, but I'm afraid it's unlawful, sir.
What do you mean?
She's married.
I see.
She's married to a British officer.
Oh, shit.
Congrats again, Alexander. Smile more. I'll see you on the other side of the war.
I will never understand you. If you love this woman, go get her. What are you waiting for?
See you on the other side of the war.
I'll see you on the other side of the war.
Theodosia writes me a letter every day. I'm keeping her bed warm while her husband is away. He's on the British side in Georgia. Trying to keep the colonies in line. Well, he can keep all of Georgia. Theodosia, she's mine. Love doesn't discriminate between the sinners and the saints. It takes and it takes and it takes, and we keep loving anyway. We laugh and we cry and we break and we make mistakes. And if there's a reason, I'm by her side. But so many have tried. Grandfather was a fire and brimstone preacher. But there are things that the homilies and hymns won't teach her. My mother was a genius. My father commanded respect. When they died, they left no instructions, just a legacy to protect. Death doesn't discriminate between the sinners and the saints. It takes and it takes and it takes, and we keep living anyway. We rise and we fall and we break and we make. And if there's a reason, I'm still alive. When everyone who loves me has died, I'm willing to wait for it.
Wait for it.
I'm willing to wait for it.
Wait for it. Like in his shoes, Hamilton doesn't hesitate. Exhibits no restraint. Takes and he takes and he takes, and he keeps winning anyway. Changes the game, plays and he raises the stakes. And if there's a reason, he seems to thrive, and so few survive. And God damn it, I'm willing to wait for it.
I'm willing to wait for it.
Life doesn't discriminate between the sinners and the saints.
general so despondent. I have taken over writing all his correspondence. Congress writes, George, attack the British forces. I shoot back, we have resorted to eating our horses. Local merchants deny us equipment, assistance. They only take British money, so sing a song of sixpence.
The cavalry's not coming.
But sir,
Alex, listen, there's only one way for us to win this. Provoke outrage. Outright.
That's right.
Don't engage. Strike by night. Remain relentless till their troops take flight.
Make it impossible to justify the cost of a fight.
Outrun.
Outrun.
Outlast.
Outlast.
Get them quick. Get out fast. Stay alive until this horrible show is past. We're gonna fly a lot of flags half-mast.
Raise a glass.
I go back to New York in my apprenticeship.
I ask for French aid. I pray that Francis sent a ship.
I stay at work with Hamilton. We write essays against slavery. And every day's a test of our camaraderie and bravery.
We cut supply lines. We steal contraband. We pick and choose our battles and places to take a stand. And every day, sir, entrust me with a command. And every day,
no,
he dismisses me out of hand. Instead of me, he promotes Charles Lee, makes him second in command.
I'm a general.
Yeah, he's not the choice I would have gone with.
He shits the bed at the Battle of Monmouth.
Everyone attack!
Retreat!
Attack!
Retreat!
What are you doing, Lee? Get back on your feet!
But there's so many of them!
I'm sorry, is this not your speed? Hamilton,
ready, sir.
Have Lafayette take the lead.
Yes, sir.
1,000 soldiers die in 100-degree heat.
As we snatch our stalemates from the jaws of defeat.
Charles Lee was left behind without a pot to piss in. He started saying this to anybody who would listen.
Washington cannot be left alone to his devices. Indecisive from crisis to crisis. The best thing he can do for the revolution is turn and go back to planting tobacco in Mount Vernon.
Don't do a thing. History will prove him wrong.
But sir,
we have a war to fight. Let's move along.
Strong words from Lee. Someone ought to hold him to it.
I can't disobey direct orders.
Then I'll do it. Alexander, you're the closest friend I've got.
Lawrence? Do not throw away your shot.
1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9.
It's the 10 dual commandments.
It's the 10 dual commandments. Number one.
The challenge demands satisfaction. If they apologize, no need for further action.
Number two.
If they don't, grab a friend, that's your second.
The lieutenant, when there's reckoning to be reckoned.
Number three.
Have your seconds meet face to face.
Negotiate a peace or negotiate a time and place.
This is commonplace, especially between recruits.
Most disputes die and no one shoots. Number four.
If they don't reach a peace, that's alright. Time to get some pistols and the doctor on site.
You pay him in advance, you treat him with civility.
You have him turn around so he can have deniability.
Five.
Go before the sun is in the sky.
Pick a place to die when it's high and dry. Number six.
Leave a note for your next of kin. Tell him where you've been. Pray that hell or heaven lets you in.
Seven.
Confess your sins, ready for the moment of adrenaline. When you finally face your opponent.
Number eight.
Last chance to negotiate. Send in your second, see if they can set the record straight.
Alexander.
Aaron Burr, sir.
Can we agree the duels are dumb and immature?
Sure, but your man has to answer for his words, Burr.
With his life, we both know that's absurd, sir.
Hang on, how many men died because Lee was inexperienced and ruinous?
Okay, so we're doing this.
Number nine.
Look him in the eye, ain't no higher. Summon all the courage you require.
1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9.
Number
10 paces.
Fire!
Lee, do you yield?
Shot him in the side. Yes, he yields.
I'm satisfied.
Yo, we gotta clear the field.
Yo, we won.
Here comes the general.
This should be fun.
What is the meaning of this? Mr. Burr,
get a medic for the general.
Yes, sir.
Lee, you will never agree with me. But believe me, these young men don't speak for me. Thank you for your service.
That's right.
Hamilton,
sir. Meet me inside.
Meet him inside. Meet him inside. Meet him inside. Meet him inside.
Son. Don't call me son.
This war is hard enough without infighting.
Lee called you out. We called his
you
bluff.
You solve nothing. You aggravate our allies to the south.
You're absolutely right. John should have shot him in the mouth. That would have shut him up.
Son.
I'm not your son.
Watch your tone. I am not a maiden in need of defending.
Charles
Lee, Thomas Conway, these men take your name and they rake it through the mud.
My name's been through a lot. I can take
it. Well, I don't have your name. I don't have your titles. I don't have your land. But if you know, if you gave me command of a battalion, a group of men to lead, I could fly above my station after the war.
Or you could die, and we need you alive.
I'm more than willing to die.
Your wife needs you alive. Son, I need you alive.
Call me son one more time.
Go home, Alexander. That's an order from your commander.
Sir.
Go home.
Volunteer army in need of a shower. Somehow defeat a global superpower. How do we emerge victorious from the quagmire? Leave the battlefield waving Betsy Ross's flag higher. Yo, turns out we have a secret weapon. An immigrant you know and love who's unafraid to step in. He's constantly confusing, confounding the British henchmen. Everyone give it up for America's favorite fighting Frenchman!
I'm picking this horse by the reins, wicked red coat weather with blood stains. And I'm never gonna stop until I make a drop of brand. I'm up and scatter the remains down. Watch me engaging them, escaping them, and raising them out. I go to France for more fun. I come back with more guns and ships. And so their balance shifts.
We rendezvous with Rochambeau, consolidate their gifts.
We can end this war in Yorktown, cut them off at sea. But for this to succeed, there's someone else we need.
I know.
Hamilton. So he knows what to do in the trench, intuitive and fluent in French, I mean.
Hamilton.
So you're gonna have to use him eventually. What's he gonna do in the bench, I mean.
Hamilton.
No one has my resilience or matches my practical tactical brilliance.
Hamilton.
You want to fight for your land back.
I need my right hand man back.
Yeah, get your right hand man back. No, you gotta get your right hand man back. I mean, you gotta put the bomb to the lender, but the sooner the better to get your right hand man back.
Alexander Hamilton, troops are waiting in the field for you.
Join us right now. Together we can turn the tide. Oh, Alexander Hamilton, I have soldiers that will yield for you. If we manage to get this right, they'll surrender my early life. The world will never be the same, Alexander. I was younger than you are now. I was given my first command. I led my men straight into a massacre. I witnessed their deaths firsthand. I made every mistake and felt the shame rise in me. And even now I lie awake, knowing history has its eyes. Young and dreamed of glory. You have no control. Who lives, who dies, who tells your story? I know that we can win. I know that greatness lies in you. But remember, from here on in, history has its eyes on you.
We're finally on the field, we've had quite a run.
Immigrants, we get the job done.
So what happens if we win?
I go back to France, I bring freedom to my people if I'm given the chance.
We'll be with you when you do.
Go, lead your men.
I'll see you on the other side.
Here we meet again.
I have not thrown away my shot. I am not thrown away my shot. Hey yo, I'm just like my country. I'm young, scrappy, and hungry. And I'm not thrown away my shot. I am not thrown away my shot.
Till the world turns upside down.
Till the world turns upside down.
I imagine death so much it feels more like a memory. This is where it gets me. On my feet, the enemy ahead of me. If this is the end of me, at least I have a friend with me. Weapon in my hand, a command of my men with me. Then I remember my allies is expecting me. Not only that, my allies is expecting. We gotta go, gotta get the job done. Gotta start a new nation, gotta meet my son. Take the bullets out your gun, the bullets out your gun. We move undercover and we move as one. Through the night we have one shot to live another day. We cannot let a stray gunshot give us away. We will fight up close, seize the moment and stay in it. It's either that or meet the business end of a bayonet. The code word is Rochambeau, take me.
Rochambeau.
You have your orders now, go man, go. And so the American experiment begins. With my friends all scattered to the winds. Noises in South Carolina, redefining bravery. We'll never be free until we end slavery. When we finally drive the British away, Lafayette is there waiting in Chesapeake Bay. How did we know that this plan would work? We had a spy on the inside. That's right,
Hercules Mulligan.
Tell a spy on the British government. I take the measurements, information, and then I smuggle it. What? To my brother's revolutionary covenant. I'm running with the Sons of Liberty, and I am loving it. See, that's what happens when you up against the ruffians. We in this shit now, somebody's gotta shovel it. Hercules Mulligan, I need no introduction. When you knock me down, I get the fuck back up again.
We'll be right back. fighting. A young man in a red coat stands on a parapet.
We lower our guns as he frantically waves their white handkerchief.
And just like that, it's over. We tend to our wounded. We count our dead.
Black and white soldiers wonder alike if this really means freedom.
Not yet.
We negotiate the terms of surrender. I see George Washington smile. We escort their men out of Yorktown. They stagger home single file. Tens of thousands of people flood the streets. There are screams and church bells ringing. And as our fallen foes retreat, I hear the drinking song they're singing.
Not a price that they're willing to pay. Insane! I cheat with the French, now I'm fighting with France and with Spain. I'm so blue. I thought that we made an arrangement when you went away. You were mine to subdue. Well, even despite our estrangement, I've got a small query for you. What comes next? You've been freed. Do you know how hard it is to lead? You're on your own. Awesome! Wow! Do you have a clue what happens now? Oceans rise, empires fall. It's much harder when it's on your own, all alone. Across the sea, when your people say they hate you, don't come crawling back to me. Da 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 da. Da 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 ya da 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 ya da. You're on your own.
Say to you, you have my eyes, you have your mother's name. When you came into the world, you cried, and it broke my heart. I'm dedicating every day to you. Domestic life was never quite my style. When you smile, you knock me out, I fall apart. And I thought I was so smart. You will come of age with our young nation. We'll bleed and fight for you. We'll make it right for you. If we lay a strong enough foundation, we'll pass it on to you. We'll give the world to you, and you'll blow us all away. Someday, someday. Yeah, you'll blow all away. Someday, someday.
Ooh, Philip, when you smile, I am undone. My son, look at my son. Pride is not the word I'm looking for. There is so much more inside me now. Philip, you outshine the morning sun, my son. When you smile, I fall apart, and I thought I was so smart. My father was.
wasn't around.
My father wasn't around.
I swear that I'll be around for you. I'll do whatever it takes.
I'll make a million mistakes.
I'll make the world safe and sound for you. Come of age with our young nation. We'll bleed and fight for you. We'll make it right for you. Strong enough foundation, we'll pass it on to you. We'll give the world to you, and you'll blow us all away. Someday, someday, yeah, you'll blow us all away.
Trial of our brand new nation, the liberty behind a liberation. I intend to prove beyond the shadow of a doubt with my assistant counsel.
Oh, Counsel Hamilton, sit down. The client, Larry Weeks, is innocent. Call your first witness. That's all you had to say.
Okay. One more thing.
Why do you assume you're the smartest in the room? Why do you assume you're the smartest in the room? Why do you assume you're the smartest in the room? That attitude might be your doom.
Why do you write like you're running out of time?
Write day and night like you're running out of time.
Every day you fight like you're running out of time.
Keep on fighting in the meantime.
Non-stop. Corruption's such an old song that we can sing along in harmony. And nowhere is it stronger than in Albany. As colonies, economies increasingly stalling. And honestly, that's why public service seems to be calling. I practice the law, practically perfected it. I've seen injustice in the world and I've corrected it. Now for a strong central democracy. If not, then I'll be Socrates throwing verbal rocks at these mediocrities.
Hamilton at the Constitutional Convention.
I was chosen for the Constitutional Convention.
There is a New York junior delegate.
Now what I'm gonna say may sound indelicate.
He goes and proposes his own form of government.
What?
His own plan for a new form of government.
What?
Talks for 6 hours, the convention is listless.
What, young man?
Yo, who the F is this?
Why do you always say what you mean? Why do you always say what you believe? Every proclamation guarantees free ammunition to your enemies.
Why do you write like it's going out of style? Write day and night like it's going out of style. Every day you fight like it's going out of style. Do what you do.
You could put up.
Alexander?
Aaron Burr, sir.
You know, that
well, it's the middle of the night.
Can we confirm, sir?
Is this a legal matter?
Yes, and it's important.
What do you need?
Burr, you're a better lawyer than me.
Okay.
I know I talk too much. I'm abrasive. You're incredible in court. You're succinct, persuasive. My client needs a strong defense. You're the solution.
Who's your client?
The new U.S. Constitution?
No.
Hear me out.
No way.
A series of essays anonymously published defending the document to the public.
No one will read it.
I disagree.
And if it fails.
Burr, that's why we need it.
The Constitution's a mess.
So it needs amendments.
It's full of contradictions.
So is independence. We have to start somewhere.
No. No way.
You're making a mistake.
Good night.
Hey, what are you waiting for? What do you stall for?
What?
We won the war. What was it all for? Do you support this Constitution?
Of course.
Then defend it.
What if you're backing the wrong horse?
Burr, we studied and we fought and we killed for the notion of a nation we now get to build. For once in our life, do you stand with pride? I don't understand how you stand to the side.
I'll keep all my hands close to my chest.
I have found a wealthy husband who will feed me in comfort.
make that work.
Alexander joins forces with James Madison and John Jay to write a series of essays defending the new United States Constitution entitled The Federalist Papers. The plan was to write a total of 25 essays that were divided evenly among the three men. In the end, they wrote 85 essays in the span of 6 months. John Jay got sick after writing 5. James Madison wrote 29. Hamilton wrote the other 51. How do you write like you're running out of time? Write day and night like you're running out of time. Every day you fight like you're running out of time. Like you're running out of time. Are you running out of time? How do you write like tomorrow won't arrive?
Best I can to get the people that I need. I'm asking you to be my right hand man.
Or state
I know it's a lot to ask.
Treasury or state
leave behind the world, you know.
Sir, do you want me to run the Treasury or State Department?
Treasury. Let's go.
Alexander.
I have to leave.
Alexander.
Look around, look around at how lucky we are to be alive right now.
So, folks, that's the first disc from the Broadway show. I'm not going to play the rest of it. That would be kind of unfair. But if you liked it and you haven't bought it, you really should. It's awesome. So I'm going to switch back to the classical music I usually use and see if I can finish off this story. This time is certainly running down.
Consideration is that people would add
/department doesn't do anything other than imbue the character's current state with the chapter.
I think there's going to be the case where it's like, all these guys is put to trigger effect. Later, we're like, do you have a trigger effect? But this really doesn't make sense. There's nothing except for that character.
Thank you. all you have to do is just pick a normal set
maybe tweet,
set the normal over there. Base normal.
Oh, yeah. But I'm going to use the I'm going to worry about, like, I have a backup.
chase anything.
Yep.
Thank you.
I made it on mine. Oh, on mine.
Is it says 5 p.m.? It's 5 p.m. on my screen.
I had perfect time on mine.
Goblins?
I'm thinking about it.
We could save it for a different day and do like a whole stream of it. Oh, that one.
Yeah, that's what I thought they were.
Thank you.
Yeah, let me come back on to this and answer a couple questions.
Okay, guys, MJ will be back in a couple minutes to answer some questions, and then right after that, we're going to have John with the character modeling. So just hang out for a minute, and he'll be right back.
Hey, John, all yours, man. I'll answer some of their questions in the chat about, you know, what I was doing, and then, you know, you just can go stream. Sorry. would be a